Okay, so I'm going to go over my new and improved mating system here on Stand Primal Fear. This is more about the system than it is the mating techniques. with the Primal Fear mod, chasing stats are different if you're going to be doing an ascended or fallen thing. So we're not going to go over any of that. Just going to go over how I got my setup. So basically, I got a level down there for like wyverns. I can do a male and six females. But I can use it for other animals too. This level I've been using for my Argies. And up there's another big level that I can do stuff. In this example, I'll do griffins up there. I'll do Argies here and wyverns there. So on this middle floor, I have 10 mutators set up and they're all pin locked. See how it says pin locked? I put the same pin on all of them. This is important so you don't have to try to get to these at all, because we're going to use this keypad system to trigger them. And we are going to use transfer tool to put the element in them. Okay, so along with those 10 mutators, we're going to use the transfer tool, and we are going to use the sill panel. So it's kind of automated. What I'll do is I'll set up my dinos, I'll trigger the keypad, well, I'll use the transfer tool to pull up the element, I'll trigger it with the keypad, I'll turn on the sill panel, and that's it. So let's show. Now, in this example, I am going to be doing griffins. So, in order to do griffins, we also are going to need one more mutator. And this mutator is set to gestation. So, it'll put out a pulse for these to mate in a gestation way, not eggs. You'll get a live birth. Normally, you can't do griffins, but here on Primal Fear they got all these other different griffins, so I'm working on celestial griffins right now. So I'll get this set up, and after I get it set up we will come back, and like I said, we'll do three types of animals at one time. We're going to do griffins, celestial. We're going to do Argies, celestial, and we're going to do celestial wyverns. So let me get them set up, and then I'll come back and I'll show you what I do. Okay, so at this point, the only thing I've put out are the griffin corns, or the, not the griffin corns, the celestial griffins. And I'm going to do the gestation pulse on them before I set out the other animals, because I want them to lay eggs. I don't want them to do a gestation pulse. The gestation pulse lasts a long time, so I can trigger that. They'll get their gestation pulse. They'll be in heat. And I'll still have enough time to put out 24 female Argies, 6 female wyverns, and a male Argie and a male wyvern. So, what you want to do is you want to, like I said, this is where the transfer tool comes in. So with the transfer tool, I have number 3 saved. I'll show you how to set one up. All right, we'll do a redundant one here. So here's number 5, and So we want to pull from our personal inventory. You could have it pull from structures. I'm just having it pull from my inventory because I always have element on me. And we want element. Okay. And we want it to go to the mutators. Okay. And then over here, we're going to put max number, 10, because we only need 10 per mutator. So now if you right-click on the 5, because that's the one we're setting up, you see it says preset saved. Okay, so now if I see if I hit 1, I got that set up for something else, and 2 set up for something else. So now we'll hit 5, and we'll hit transfer, and you'll see 110 items transferred. So it put 10 sheets of element in each one of those 10 mutators down there, and 10 sheets of element in this mutator up here. See? Create, allow breeding pulse. I can get in there and do that manually, but I'm going to show you the pin code way. Sometimes I can't get in there because of the way they're placed. So the mutator up there has a different pin code than these 10 mutators down here. So I'll go over to the keypad. And I will hit 1, 2, 3, 4. That's what I set that pin code at. And you'll notice in a second, bam, just did the mutation. Now, if you get your spyglass on, you can see in the window on the left where it says in heat, 21,000. Now, it's going to take a lot of time for that to click down. So we'll have plenty of time to set up our other two animals. So that's not a worry. And because it only set off that one, these mutators, see, they're ready to go. They're all ready for the mutation pulse. So now I'm going to get my RGs ready. And then once I get the RGs and the wyverns set up, we'll come back and we'll go from there. So I'll continue once everything's set up. Okay, so as you can see, I got my RGs down below. I got my wyverns on the bottom level. So that's one male and 24 females. And I'm getting up there in levels with the RGs, and I gotta go through all that. I did a video on how you get to where I'm at. Once you get high up in levels, even with 24 females, sometimes I'm going 10, 12 rounds before I get an increase. Sometimes I get 2-3 rounds back to back. But that's not what I'm here to show you. More or less, I'm showing you just my method. But like I said, the higher up in levels you get, the longer it takes to get a level increase. Now with 10 mutators, we're getting 20 levels when we do get an increase. So that's not bad. And my 24 females that I'm using have no mutations, and the male has a shit ton of mutations. Because if I get a level increase on a round, that becomes the new male. If it's a female, I switch its sex over, pokeball it, and then it'll stay as a male. If it's already a male, we're good to go. But anyways, let's get on with what I was here to show you. As you can see, these are still in heat, 21,000. So it didn't go down that much while I did all that. I'm going to turn off the spyglass because I hate those green outlines. So these are all ready to go. As you can see, everybody is still, even the male, is in enable mating, right? So I never turned on mating for any of these. Sorry, my birds are hungry. Same with the wyverns, same with the griffins. The only thing I did with the griffins was give them a gestation pulse, so that when I do the mating pulse, they'll mate, but it won't be an egg. It'll be a a live birth, and they'll mate, and then they'll gestate. So okay, so now what we want to do is set up, trigger the mutators. Now remember, we used the transfer tool with the pre-program that we did, and it put 10 sheets of element and everything. Then we went over to the keypad and we triggered off that one up there for the gestation pulse. So now we're going to go to the keypad, and I'm going to use a different code, which is the code I put into the 10 mutation ones, and that's 6969, because I want them to fuck. Alright, so as you can see, those are going off, right? Bam. It's 10 mutation pulses. They're still not, you know, they're irradiated, as you can see. Okay, so now what we want to do is go over to the soul terminal. Hold D, go to options, newborn auto trap. Click this box here, enable. Now what this box does is, if a live birth is born, it automatically pokeballs it and sucks it in. When an egg hatches, it automatically pokeballs it and sucks it in. So now there's this mating pulse. Hit enable, and you gotta have this on to do that. And once you do that, as you can see, now they are mating. And that's from the mating pulse. For this to work though, as you can see there, it says newborn trap active, requires soul traps. So always make sure you got plenty of Pokeballs in there. And I'll show you that again. Just hold E, go to options, newborn auto trap. And make sure you enable this first, and then enable that to make a mate. Now if I hit disable, they will stop mating and go back to not mating anymore. If you put an animal out after you hit enable, it's not gonna mate. They have to be out already when you hit enable, because it's just a pulse, just like the mutators. So you can actually leave this on at all times, and then when you want them to mate, hit enable. Okay. So my Argies are mating. You can see my Griffins are mating. And my Wyverns are mating. Okay. Another thing you want to do on settings is, if you go into E, go to options, go to automation, and make sure you get fertilized egg collection and fertilized egg incubation checked. So what that'll do is, after they lay an egg, even with my incubator on, I think it will still pick up the eggs. Okay, here we go, here we go. So everybody's mating, everybody's laying eggs. Okay, so once they stop their thingy, we soul ball all these back up, and yeah, the eggs are still sitting there. But I'm pretty sure even... we'll see. I could be wrong about that, and if I'm wrong, we'll fix that. We'll turn off the incubator. But I think the soul panel will say, okay, yeah, they're incubating, but they've been out there for a while, and we'll override it, because I think it already did pick up a couple eggs. Let's see, did it pick up any eggs? No. So, maybe I was wrong about that. Let's turn off our incubator. But you know what? Yep, there they go. I think I have left it on, but I could be wrong. I think I might be wrong. Wouldn't be the first time. Let's put all these females back. Now, these females are all copies. They're the same female. I don't know which mod that allows us to do that, but you can blueprint a cryopod in the blueprint augment station thing, and then from that blueprint, oh, I hope these are done mating. Yeah. you can then, in the Smith-Cator, make copies, and you can make as many as you want. So I have like 144 of each animal, typically. Let's put those back. 142 man. Put the wyverns away. Okay, so male goes there. Now, unfortunately, I was doing 12 wyverns when I was doing it out in the open, but only 6 fit in here. Not too big of a deal, you know. This is just the way I've been doing it. Wyverns are a little bit bigger. They take up a lot more room. Not height-wise, but width and length. Okay, so all my eggs are in here. They all were picked up automatically. They're all incubating. I'm not going to go... I'll show you how this all works when we hatch it. We'll turn the incubator back on. I still think it'll pick up the eggs. Maybe it just takes longer. And these guys are done breeding, but they're gestating. Now, this gestation sucks because 26 minutes before we get a live birth. In that 26 minutes, though, sometimes I hatch those eggs. I go through them. If I find one for the next level, I'll even give them the kibble, get them raised, and breed another round of Argies and Wyverns before these ever give a live birth. Depends on how much I'm trying to do at one time. Sometimes I just wait. So, let's see, these shouldn't take long. So when these eggs are ready, we'll come back and we'll hatch them, and I'll show you how the newborn trap thing works, because when you put the egg out, it'll hatch and the babies will get sucked into soul balls. But that's why it's important to already have a stack of soul balls inside the soul terminal. Soul terminal does a lot of things. You can use it for egg production of unfertilized eggs. You can use it for snow owl pellets. And you just put the snow owls in there and turn on the miscellaneous poop or whatever it is, and it'll produce those pellets, and it doesn't account towards your live animals being out in the world. On this server, we get 100. See, tame limit 13 of 100. So you only have, you know, so many out. Now, vivariums is a nice way, but you can only put, you know, so many in there. Whereas in the soul terminal, say you want a lot of owl pellets, you can put 30, 40 owls in there. I've got a soul terminal with elder phoenixes in it, and they're producing pearls. I've got soul terminals with alpha, apex, toxic, and all those different types of ones that you would normally have in the vivarium. I got them all in one soul terminal, and they're producing unfertilized eggs for me. And it produces a lot more eggs, and it does it a lot faster for you. And like I said, you don't have to have just 10. You can have 30 of each if you want. It holds 300, so. Okay, so my RG eggs are ready. And we are just going to drop them on the ground. And that's it. Just drop them all. See, as they hatch, they got sucked up. So now if you go in here, there's all the babies. Now, did I get a level increase? I think I'm at 1277. And there's a 1277, but I don't see a 1297. But like I said, once you get up, after you get over 1,000, it's really slow to get those level increases. Before 1,000, I would say maybe 3 out of 12 rounds I wouldn't get a level increase, but most rounds I did. After 1,000, after 1,200, it's been, geez, I can go 12, 13 rounds before I get that 120 level increase. So it gets really slow once you get up there. So it all depends on how persistent you are, how much time you have, how much element you have. Because, you know, you do it, okay, so say you do 12 rounds and you get no level increase, but you do on the 13th. Well, 12 rounds times 10 element sheets in each mutator, you know, that's 1,000, that's 100 sheets every round, so that's 1,200 sheets to go 12 rounds, and then, you know, to go beyond that. So it can get expensive. It's not something you don't want to get into mass mating like this till you get to the point where you got a crap ton of element. But once you do, then that's when you get to do stuff like this. And the higher levels will give you a better ascended animal. I've got a Wyvern right now that's 1216, so he was ascended at 716. No, he was higher than that. Yeah, he was ascended at yeah. And then after adding, yeah, he was ascended at, he was 716. Then I put the points into him, it brought him up to 966. And then I ascended him and put the points in him, and that brought him up to 1216. I'm at 1052 right now, so if I ascend one now, that'll take it up to 1500. But you gotta put a lot of work into it. So, so that all depends on how much time do you have, how much resources do you have, how persistent are you in getting a better animal. So let's do these Wyverns just like we did the Argies. And you can see 1052 is the male, so that's where I'm at on them. Now watch when they hatch, boom, 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 and there they go. Did I get higher than a 1052? Probably not. They're all pretty low level. After I got over 1,000 on the Wyverns, they've gotten really slow. So the only thing we're waiting for now are the Griffins. And it'll be 20 minutes. So when those are done, we'll come back and we'll catch the live birth and watch them get sucked up. And that'll be it. And hopefully that gives you a good idea of how I get the system automated. I don't have to put element into anything. I use the transfer tool. I don't have to trigger anything. I use the keypad. And I'm doing three types of animals. I could put Rexes in here. I could put a lot of things. You know, I've done Thylos up in here. I've, with the Argies and Wyverns, I've done Megalotheriums. So there's, you know, plenty of room to do most animals. The Wyverns, I was having better success out in the open in a big field, just because I could get 12 of them around the male instead of 6. So it's taken a lot longer with only 6. But on Primal Fear, there's very few places where you've got a nice big open field where you're safe. And I can't stress that enough, where you're safe to have your animals sit out there and breed without Origins and Celestials and whatnot attacking you. So when the we'll come back as soon as these Griffins are ready and we'll go from there. Okay, so we're almost ready. We've got under a minute. on the gestation. So in less than a minute, all of these babies are going to come out, and they're going to come out live birthed, and they're going to immediately get sucked into the soul terminal. And because these are live births, because we did a gestation pulse, because this is a griffin, again, griffins don't usually breed, so you got to set it to gestation, and then you can force them to breed. Now, I don't know in vanilla if you can do that with griffins, I wouldn't see why not, but on the Primal Fear mod, the Griffacorns and the Celestial Griffins and the Light and the Dark Griffins and all that, it seems to work this way. Oh, there they go. You can hear them. See, they're just flying out the butts and bam, get sucked up. So you don't even have to, when you usually hatch an egg or an animal's born and they start walking around, you know, when it's a mammal and the live birth, and then you gotta go up and hit E to imprint and all that. You don't have to do all that. All that's taken care of. They're sucked straight into that soul terminal down there. And as you can see in the soul terminal, here are my griffins. Doesn't look like I got a higher level. Now, like I said, you don't always. Oh, yes, I did. I got a 738. I had a 718 to start out with. So, that is my system. Three animals at once. I suppose you could maybe get away with doing a couple more levels. I'm not quite sure. With the soul terminal and the mutators, the ranges, you can turn on the range, whatever, but the reason I got it like this is I've got this built on a cliff because Primal Fear dinos are fucking crazy and will fuck your shit up. So it's up here nice and safe, all fits in the shield nice and well, and I don't have to worry. And most animals, you know, you saw I was able to put 24 RGs in. I got 12 griffins, and once I get up in levels, I can add another 12 in here comfortably. Some things I'll have to do, you know, just 12. And then, like, Wyvern 6. I'm sure there's a couple other big animals I'll have to do 6. But all automated. I don't have to go in and, you know, hit this to start it. I don't have to put element in my mutators because we use the transfer tool, and then the keypad triggers them. Just remember to have your gestation mutator and your radiation mutators with different pins. So when you go hit the pin code, boop, 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 it only sets off the ones you want. I hope this is helpful. Take the information and do, you know, maybe expand it your way, cut out some of the steps, whatever. This is just to kind of show you how I'm doing it. People are always asking, you know, what are you doing? What am I doing wrong? How come this is da-da-da-da-da? Maybe this will answer some of your questions. And like I said, once you get up in levels, I'll go rounds. Like, I'm at 1277 on these RGs, and I'm going 12, 14 rounds sometimes of 24 females, and I'm not getting a level increase, but then, bam, I'll get a level increase in the next round. I might get a level increase. But I use the same females over and over and over. And then when I get a level increase, I take that new one and put it in. Now, if the new one is a female, I just do a sex change on her with the mutator, pokeball it so it stays and doesn't revert back. And then now it's a male, and I'll use that male, and then the same females over and over. Don't worry what side the mutations are going on, maternal, paternal, because it won't matter, because ultimately maternals, none of them have mutation, and just your paternal has all the mutations, and it'll keep your animals clean, and you should have maybe one mutation on the maternal side of the baby, and most of them will be on the paternal side. But sometimes it goes both ways, but it doesn't really matter as long as the females are clean. 0-0. No mutations on either side. Doesn't matter what the father has. Doesn't matter if some are on one side, some are on the other. As long as the females are all 0-0. So I hope that helps you out. And have fun with it and do your own thing. Thanks for watching the video.